Okay, to kind of give you an idea of the next step we're going to do is that we're going to make a strap. The strap is going to have two parts. One part will hold the buckle. And it will basically connect to the bag like this. So what we're going to do is that we're going to make a strap to fit this buckle, because I want the strap to be adjustable. So this buckle is 1 inch from post to post. So what I'm doing, I'm going to take this ruler. This ruler is 2 inches wide. So I'm going to cut out a 2 inch wide strip. And once I cut out the 2 inch wide strip, I'm going to glue it, fold it inward on both sides, which will make it to be a 1 inch strap. So I'm going to go ahead and trace this out, and then I will cut it out. Now that I have 2 inch line cut out, so what I'll do, I'll cut this out. And if you notice, I'm keeping pressure on the ruler so it does not move on me. Okay. Now what I will do is that I will get the scissors where it did not cut it all the way through. I will go back and cut that. Now that I have my 2 inch strip, what I will do, I will glue it, I will fold it inward, and then I will start putting the strap together. Now this is going to be the second part of the strap, which will hold the buckle. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use a water-based cement glue from Tandy Leather. I'll use this to glue the strap together. Like I say, what I'll do, I'll let this dry for a minute before I fold it. Okay, now that I've let this dry for a minute, I will take it, fold it inward, now this is one way of making straps. When I make the next bag, I will show you a second way. What happened is that the strap will go on the buckle like this. But before we do that, what we will do is that we will cut the tips, give the tips a shape, and then we will sew it. But before we do that, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to glue the second part of the strap. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to glue the second part of the strap. Dry for a couple of minutes and then we will fold it like we did the first one. Okay, now that we have let this dry, now what we will do is fold it inward. And what I'm doing, when I fold it over, when I press, I'm pressing right close to where the line is here. More than I'm pressing here. I'm pressing more on the inside than I am on the outside. That gives it a nice flat surface when you do that. That also allow you to control the width of each side to where you're folding in evenly. And remember, if it's not even, you can always pull it back apart. And refold it. Now that we have this done, next thing we'll do, we will cut the tips of the straps and then we will sew them. These are strap end cutters. They're two different shapes and they will give your the tip of your straps a nice shape to them. What I'm going to do on the shorter strap, I'm going to use this one here on both ends, and then on the longer strap, I'm going to use one on each end of the strap. So what I would do, if you look at that strap now, it doesn't have a shape to it, so I would take this one and it gives it a shape. And I'll do the same thing on this end. Now on this one here, which is the longer strap, I will use this cutter on one end and then I will use this cutter on the other end, and I'll show you why I'm using two different ones on this strap here. I'm using this one on the other end, and when I finish, I'll show you why. Now, the reason why I use this particular cutter for this end is because this is the end will be going through the buckle. This one will be going through the buckle, so you want that one to have a different shape than what this one here will have. Okay, now we're going to sew them. Sewn, what we're going to do now, we're going to cut the hole for the buckle pin to go through. So what I will do, I will bend it. Well, I will fold the leather where I would like for it to fold. So when I put the buckle on, I'll put a strap keeper across here. So what I'll do, I fold it. And this is a oblong punch. See, it have a different shape than what the tip cutters have. So what I will do, I will line it up to where it's centered. And I would do what I would do is now that we have the straps sewn, the next thing I'm going to do, I would take the strap, wrap it around the buckle, and get the fold that I want, and I'm going to punch a hole where this stem is going to go. So what I would do, I would take this punch, which is an oblong punch, put it where I made my fold. I'll just tap it to make sure that it's centered. So what I will do, I would hit it from the front, rock it to the back, then I go straight down to the front, to the back, and see how it cuts through. And then this is where I will put so you can see how that's going to go. Okay, one thing that I forgot to do was cut out a strap keeper, which is when you take the buckle and you put it onto this strap, you need something to keep this part of the strap in place. And you'll see this on belts. And this is the same process as making a belt. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut out a piece that's going to be 1 inch by 4 inch. And I will fold it just like I did the strap itself. I will fold it and make a strap keeper that will go here around this part of the strap. So just to show you what I'm talking about, I'll do a 1 inch by 4 inch. So I have my 1 inch by 4 inch. Then I would take it. I'm going to glue it. I'm going to use the contact cement glue because I just have a small piece and it dries much quicker. I'm going to let that set for a couple of seconds. Basically what I would do, I would take it just like I made the strap. I would just fold it inward. Now this one I do not have to use the tip cutter to cut the tip. I'll just use the scissors because you will not see it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to sew it and then I'm going to put a rivet in it and attach it to where it goes like this. That's your strap holder. But I'm going to sew this and then we will attach the strap to the hardware. And then the last thing we will need to do is put the hardware on the bag and this bag will be finished. Thing we're going to do is put all the pieces of the strap together with the hardware. So the first thing I'm going to do is the belt keeper. So I'm going to punch a hole. And then I will use a small rivet . I'll put the cap on the back. And then I will take the hand setter and close that cap. Now the next thing I will do is that I will take the buckle, put it on this part of the strap, close it, punch my hole, and what I'm doing, I'm just making sure that I'm not too close to this opening here. I'll punch a hole here. This one I'm going to use a medium rivet. Put the cap on the back. Then I will slide the keeper onto here. Let's see here, is that too big? You know what, I'm going to take this keeper off and I'm going to make it, it's a little too wide. See how big that is? So I'm going to tighten that up. I'm gonna make it a little shorter, well, a smaller. So what I'll do, I will take these rivets out and adjust this. And this will give you a chance to see how to take the rivets off if you put a rivet in and you need to take it out. Okay, this is what I do to take rivets out. If I put a rivet in and I need to replace it, I just take a screwdriver and I just try to raise it up enough to I can take these pliers and pull the cap off, and then I just start see how that comes off. And trust me, you will have to do this. So now what I will do, I will just punch another hole to make it smaller, to make this belt keeper smaller. Now I'll just take a new rivet, put it in, put the cap on, take the hand press, press it in. Now that's much better. That's much better. Now what I will do, I'll punch a hole right here. And basically what I want to do is make sure that when I punch the hole from this side, I'm going to go in maybe about right here, not too close to the tip of the back side of the strap. So I'll just take my punch my hole, use a medium, put the cap on the back, close it. That's what that looks like. Now my next step is going to be spring-loaded hook. I put the other end of the strap inside of here. So what I will do now, I will put a hole right here. That adjusted. Then I will put my rivet put the cap on the back, and then I will punch another hole. Second hole right here. No, I'm going to re-punch that and bring it over a little bit. You don't have to worry about the hole showing because the cap will hide that, but I need to bring it over to where it's centered. And I will close these two. Now this part will go here. Now what I need to do is to put this part of the strap on this spring-loaded hook. Now when I cut the tips, I did one tip with a pointed and one had a different shape. The pointed end is the one that will go through the buckle. So what I will do now, take this strap, put it through the hardware, I think I'll put two rivets on here. Punch one hole, center that up. Put my rivet in. Put the cap on the back. Punch my second hole. My rivet in. Put my cap on the back. I think I'm gonna bring that rivet over a little more. I did not get that centered. If you have to punch a second hole, that's okay because the rivet will hide it. It's better to do it right than to do it wrong to where people can see that it's not centered. See, once I close that, you will not see that second hole. So I will close these two. Then this will connect to here. Now the next thing we're going to do, we're going to punch the holes in the strap. And
next thing we're going to do,
we're going to punch the hole to adjust the strap. And we're going to put some eyelets in. Now, the punch that I use to do the rivets were a little smaller than the one that I'm using to punch the hole for the eyelets. And what I normally do is that I will punch the first hole. Well, for example, for this strap, I'm going to make it, the first hole is going to be 5 inches from the tip. So what I will do, I will just put a mark 5 inches from the tip. And then from that point, I'll use this adjustable ruler. You can get this at any fabric store. And where I put the first mark, I'll put this blue arrow at the first mark and then the next mark. So I have it set at 1 inch. At 1 inch. So each hole will be 1 inch apart. So I will just tap that. I will do it again. I'm going to put 5 eyelets in, which will allow me to adjust it. The strap at least 5 inches. You know what, I'm gonna go ahead and do 6. I'll do 6. So now what I'll do, I'll punch the holes. Now that I have all 6 holes punched, I will take the eyelet. I put the eyelet in on the front side of the strap. Now these are the same pieces if you have some shoes or sneakers that have strings. This is what the strings go through. They're called eyelets. Now, for the rivet, we use this hand press. Now, both of these hand presses are the same. The only thing I change out is the die. And we have several different hand press because we do teach classes. But you only need one. But you can change the die out. So this one here was for the rivet. This die here is for the eyelet. If you notice, it have a pin here. So when I put the eyelet on and I press down, well then this pin will go down and it would allow the eyelet to fold over to close. So I'll take it, turn it upside down. That's what it looks like. So I'm going to close these. They do have setters. If you're not able to afford a hand press, they do have setters that you can use. They don't close as clean, but you can use them. So what will happen now, the strap will go in like this. You close it. You put it through the strap keeper. And that is what that would look like. So what I'm going to do, the next thing we're going to do is the hardware. And like I say, after that, this bag will be finished. And really, you really don't even have to put hardware on here because the weight of these tips. But just for security, we're going to put hardware on it. And it gives it a different look. So at this point, this could be a man's bag or a woman's bag. The hard work can determine if it's a man bag or it's just a woman bag. But right now, it can be either or. Okay, so we will do the next step, which will be the hardware. Okay, this is the hardware that I've chosen to install. It have two parts. This part goes on the flap of the bag, and this part goes on the front of the bag. So what I'm going to do is install what's going on the flap first. So what I'll do, take my screwdriver, now this one have two screws on the back. I will loosen the two screws, and I'm going to keep the two screws inside of this case to keep from losing them, because they're so small. It's easy to put them down and not be able to find them once you have put them down somewhere. So what I will do, I will take the front part of the hardware, which it's a front plate and a back plate. I'll take the front plate and I'll lay it on the flap of the bag, and I'll decide where I'm going to install it. Now, you can put it anywhere you want to. I mean, you can turn it any way you want to. You can turn it slant, you can turn it vertical, but I'm going to turn this one horizontal. And I want to make sure that I'm pretty much in the middle of the bag. So I'm not really measuring it, I'm just eyeballing it. And then once I decide where I'm going to install it, what I will do, I will press down, I will get an indention, now since this leather is so dark and I can't see it that well, I'm going to turn it over to the lighter side. And I'll do the same thing. I'll press down. Now that I can see much better, I will take a pencil and just draw right on the indention that I have. So what I did, I just drew around the line of the imprint. Like a circle on each end, which indicate this area right here. So now what I will do, I will take my X-Acto knife, and then I will cut and take the straps off, so I'm not trying to work with the straps on the bag. So now what I will do, I want to have to stand up. I will cut on my line. Now what I did, I cut on my lines, but where I drew the circle, I'm going to punch a hole there. So what I will do, I will use a punch to punch a hole . Now that I have the hole punch, what I will do is cut this. Now this will become my opening for putting my hardware on. Now what I'm going to do, move this back out of the way. I will take this cloth, put it underneath so I don't scratch up the hardware, and I will just take a screwdriver. You want to make sure that the hole is not cut too big. So in that way, if it's too big, you can't put anything back on it. But if it's not big enough, you can just keep working it until you are able to . Now with this particular hardware, it does take time, so you have to be patient with yourself and with what you're doing, because the whole idea is to get it to where you can put this one back on . Okay, now that's the flap with the hardware on. Now, in order to put the second part on, which have two prongs, what I always do, I always stuff the bag. And the reason why, if I don't stuff the bag and I go ahead and I line this up, put the hardware on, once I start putting things in the bag, it's not going to fit the way it should. So you want to stuff the bag as if the bag is already in use. I just use the stuffer. Now that will fit much better. Now the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to use these clamps to make sure that the side of the bag it's lined up the way I want it to be lined up. See, so now what I'll do is that I will make my imprint. I press down. Now I have my two marks where I'm going to punch my holes, right here. Okay, now that I have my two marks, the next thing I'm going to do is take the tissue out, and then I will use these two pads to put inside, because I'm going to punch those two holes, and I don't want to go all the way through and punch through the back of the bag. So what I will do, I will punch. Punch the hole. See, that one disappeared on me. Punch the hole. Now I'm going to take those two prongs, and I will put them inside those two holes. That is so off. Let me go back and punch that right. If I could put that in. Now the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to take this washer, and I'm going to put it on the back. What I'm doing inside, I'm putting this on the back, and then I'm going to close these. When I close them, I'm going to close them outward. I'll close them away from each other so they will lay down flat. I'll just use a screwdriver to bend them out. You have to work with it. Okay, now that I have this on, what I will do now, I will use some of the same leather that I use for the lining. I will cut the piece by maybe 1.5 inches by 2 inches. And I'll use the contact cement glue. To glue this, and then I will put this over the back of that, those pins, to give it a finished look. Now what I will do, I will restuff it. Now this is the finished bag. Your font, your side, your back. Open it. So that's what it's like to make a tote bag, or a computer bag, or a messenger bag. They're all the same process. And like I said, my next video, I will do one where we're going to sew it where it's sewn on the inside. This is sewn on the outside, but the next one will be to where it's sewn on the inside. Now, like I always say, if you know anyone that's trying to learn how to work with leather, or someone that's already working with leather and looking for new techniques, tell them about our YouTube channel and pass it on to everyone that you know, and send me a message. Let me know what it is that you'd like for me to do, and just understand it takes time to do each one of these videos, but I will get to any request that is made. I will get to those. And thank you for watching.